Cognitive knowledge and conflict knowledge, that is the breaking point. So then social reaction, he will say, if you see norms, norms for what? There are many people escape. You don't talk about their norms, their violations. Then starts conflict, violence. Social reaction theory is a very good theory, particularly the primitive aspect also that we have. I tell you one example. Our former chief minister wanted to reform, you know, commercial sex workers living in Mumbai. One special train was arranged so that he was there in Mumbai, brought 800 people all the way to Mumbai, staying there for years together. And when they reached there, they were kept in the protective home. We call it a vigilance home, protective homes. Most of them were taken all the way, cheating them. When they were all children, they became adolescents, adults. They came to the great home, they are going to see their parents. When they went there, they were not accepted. I know two more girls, they should get married. We have already finished everything as we did for the rituals. Please go back. About 800, not even 50 escaped back to Chennai. They were all forced to go back. This is the social reaction, what is the same reaction? See that from the crime from their perspective. But we react, we don't react towards corruption. That way when there is a time of election also, who has committed less corruption will be given preference than the person who has committed more corruption. This is the way you vote, you know. That is a, there is no other alternative for us also. Social reaction. But from the delicate perspective, it's very important. This is one of the labeling. Suppose a boy in a village is taken, a report is given by the police, he's taken. The social stigma started, the labeling process starts. The labeling process started, I think of. One vessel was taken from one place. My neighbor was working in the housing board. He's a highly corrupt fellow. He's an agent of the minister. He was telling, catch him, beat him, take him. So that he was taken. And the people around told him, this fellow has committed theft. That the process of labeling started. So that informally he is labeled as a delinquent. He will go to the police station. There also police station says, yes, he is proved beyond doubt. He is taken to the juvenile justice board. Court of directors, yes, you are delinquent. Informally, he was delinquent. Yeah. And again, when he goes back, he goes to the correctional institution, comes back. We were discussing about aftercare. There is no acceptance on the part of the society. He thinks, I want to be a reformed person, but the society did not accept me. I want to be a non-delinquent, so I want to change myself. Why should I be delinquent? Because anything comes on the street, the police comes immediately and takes me back. So that a strong labeling that has medium, a change within the individual, a personality changing things. I want to be a non-delinquent, but the society does not permit me delinquent, so that I go back. This is how the recidivism is the outcome. A number of preventive measures are there. I hope to explain to you. My time is over. Thank you so much.
Okay, as just now we heard Professor Clubber Rajan talking about, and we begin with what is delinquency. So, when we say delinquency, many of you have answered that particular word's answer, that it is some deviant behavior, isn't it? Some type of behavior which is not up to the norms of the society. So when we say this, I mean, this become a very typical traditional line, norms, the behavior which is not as per the norms of the society. When we say this, it varies from time to time, period to period, and society to society. Like, for example, at one point of time, by the children, the very simple behavior when elderly people enter into their room or they come nearby to those people, they used to wish, they used to stand up if they were sitting, isn't it? But do you having a feeling, or all of us have not noticed that this particular thing is not existing anymore in the society? What I'm trying to tell you that all of you, as I came to know, are from the criminology field, either teaching or researching upon either in the law or social sciences. So these are the typical traditional bookish things, that deviancy, definition, juvenile delinquency. But when we think about its practicality, first of all, it existed from all times, time immemorial, till date. And if we go through certain data, certain statistics, all of you must have gone through. Nowadays it is so much easily available, all sorts of reports, whether of our country's National Crime Report Bureau or of other police bodies, or it can be international scenario, their statistics, their country's increase in crime. So you can find out there's always a gradual increase. In fact, in our country, simple, which can be the tip of the iceberg. I may say, because not all the cases are reported. National Crime Report Bureau, which is taken to be one of the most authentic report, which of course is not reporting all the offenses or all the crimes or all the delinquencies committed by the children or by the elderly people, still show that it has become the 3 times within a period of 10 years. All right. So what I was trying to question from all of you, that the behaviors which we used to, there is a difference between me and you also. Maybe I am 10 year older to some of you or 20 year older. If my mother, even today, she comes in front of me, I will definitely get her. Whatever she will say, even if I agree or I do not agree, as mama, I will say like that. Instead of that, today's children, even if they are 10 year old or 15 year old, they always have a feeling of arguing with you. They have their own viewpoint. Sometimes, of course, it's good also. But they always have their own tendency. They are working with the computer. When you enter into the room, they don't get up. Even they may be sitting cross-legged. But that is not taken to be any delinquent or wrong behavior in today's scenario. So somehow, gradually, we have also started accepting certain behaviors which are not very much delinquent in nature. And once upon a time, they could have been taking a falat path. ये ठीक नहीं है, ये रॉन्ग है, ऐसे थोड़ी ना बिहेव करा जाता. नंबर वन. नंबर टू, आज लगा राजन वेरी ब्रिलियंट सेड दैट ऑल ऑफ अस मस्ट बी सम टाइप ऑफ डेलिक्वेंट फीचर्स इन अस, अदरवाइज वी आर नॉट नॉर्मल. दैट्स ट्रू. एक्चुअली इन आवर चाइल्डहुड वी ऑल रिमेंबर, अब गुल्लक के पैसे चुरा लेते थे, दूसरे भाई बहन के अपना ले लिया, किसी को मार दिया, किसी के साथ प्रैंक करा. सो सम टाइप ऑफ बिहेवियर्स which were taken to be normal, but if they perpetually and gradually continue, may take the shape of some kind of delinquency. So delinquency is in some or the other form exists in every human being, but that may, it depends upon how it is taken up in future, how it is taken up, how it grows into a person. Now another important question which comes up when we talk of delinquency, so all of us understand it is some behavior which is not up to the norms of the society, which is somehow in conflict with law. Nowadays the word is conflict of law, because delinquency is taken to be a little more stigmatized word, so we use the word conflict of law. So behaviors which are in conflict of laws and which are liable to be to the punishment are the deviant behavior. And and that exists in every society. With the passage of time, we always talk of dealing with that delinquency and to differentiate that delinquent behavior with that of the typical crime. So from now onward, I want to go to some sites which are very general in nature. I will be explaining each of them. Children constitute quite a number of population. What is the population of the children in our country? Approximately, as per the census also, they constitute actually almost half of the population. Children up to the age of 18 years, they constitute almost 44% of population, which means they are quite large in number, and their behavior, their tendencies, their culture, their upbringing matters a lot. Now I want to tell you some. When we say delinquents, first of all we should understand what is the difference between crime and delinquency. So delinquency is an act or behavior which is not normal. Abnormality can be either superior or inferior. When we say this word, behavior which is not normal, which is not up to the norms of the society. So norms of the society is one thing. When we say abnormal, abnormality can be either superior or inferior. So superior people are genius and they can be beneficial to the society. However, inferiors, due to some of their reasons, they can become harmful to the society. When the behavioral pattern is harmful, it may become sometimes harmful to the society. Now, juvenile delinquency, it can be characterized by antisocial behavior that is beyond parental control and therefore subject to legal action. It is a violation of the law committed by the juvenile and not punishable by death or life imprisonment. Then, this I was talking about child population, and accordingly, now not the whole population is involved in delinquency, but according to data and statistics which you can find out, it is a large number of children who have been found to be indulged in delinquency. Now another question which is always raised, that most of the time delinquency can be due to the reason of, what do you think, what can be the reason for children? This is what I want to listen. The first and foremost reason which comes for is poverty. Yes, it may be, but do you think it is always the poor children who will end up in delinquency? Especially looking into nowadays news, nowadays reports, and nowadays TV and other shows. In fact, it is children who are from very good and affluent families. Abhi recently, two bachchon ne milke apni grandmother ko maar daala. Sometimes you find out that they kill their own parent, or they do something wrong in the school, they do something wrong by lifting the cars. Though they are having their own cars, the children who are belonging to the family having 2-3 cars or other automobile vehicles, but despite that they are indulging into that type of fact. What is the reason now?
Rich lifestyle,
to be indulged in more luxurious life, to be at par, to be peer pressure, ke humare paas aur zyada cheeze ho. It is a show of work. So not always the poverty, which was otherwise was cited as one of the most important factor. Even if we talk of factors such as biological factors or physical factors or mental factors, I'm coming on to the slide. Whatever I'm giving you in the slide, that is a typical information provided in all sort of books and on the internet. So these are the reasons, but I want to discuss it beyond today. First talking about those things and then discussing it beyond today. Like for example, the factors of juvenile delinquency which have been generally cited and which has been found out through various case studies And these are physical factors, mental factors, home conditions, school conditions, labor conditions, occupational conditions. Previously also it has been referred, and this is very true also, that physical factors may be responsible for a child being delinquent. Medical, mental factors are of course there. Home conditions are necessarily one of it, and very majorly of it. In fact, they all these conditions all have their connection within it also. But it is a physical factor. The children who are victims or who are subjected to malnutrition, so they always have a wish to eat better and better and to satisfy their this hunger or to satisfy their nutritional needs, because of which they can commit as small as delinquency to go to some wedding or to go to some party and meet up afterwards. So what type of delinquency will it constitute? Will it be subject to or liable to punishment, or some type of criminal system punishes for that or not? Then sometimes because of lack of sleep. Now when we say lack of sleep, it can be due to some physical condition of illness, or it can be due to some physical comfort. It's comfort also, and comfort again is directly related to the poverty or the economic conditions of the family. So these are also automatically, and now when they say a person who is not slept properly or who had not had the his leisure or rest properly may be deviated. May because we also sometimes don't we feel we are irritated, and that time we may cite the reason that I didn't have a proper sleep, or I have so many other things on my mind, or I have so much of other irritation due to certain other reasons. So we always cite those type of reasons. That means if we are at a comfort level, our behavior is very normal, our behavior is very much within the pattern. Otherwise, it goes beyond to it whenever something is against our, you know, conditions. So these are the typical factors, physical factors. You can take malnutrition, lack of sleep. There can be many more. I'm not saying the list is exhausted. In this also there can be many more factors. You can see some of them. Then it can be mental factors. Again, mental defects, some type of psychoneurosis, repression and substitution, inferiority complex of the child. Then adolescent emotional inability. We'll talk about these points further. Then sex habits and experience, mental conflicts, etc. These are the situations, or these are the reasons or factors which may lead a child to indulge in delinquency. Then home conditions. You can see these ones are also connected to the first and second one. Material deficiencies in the family, material excess, broken homes and unhappy relations. Previously discussed. Yes, broken homes and unhappy relations. When I am referring to broken home, you can understand that means either mother or father living separately, or unhappy relations, you can understand that always fights are going on in the family, always some type of conflict in the family, fighting within the parent or with the siblings, or one of the sibling and the parents. So some type of conflictive situation can lead another child into the delinquency, and this is very common thing which most of the time occurs in most of the families. Some children live with it and don't indulge into it. Some children take it otherwise and may indulge into some delinquency. Then mental, physical and abnormality of parents and siblings, that is stigma of illegitimacy, lack of parent. If you can define all these, that these can be, and this again the list can be much more. Then school conditions also sometimes leads the children to indulge into their delinquency. I think most of you can relate to it. Sometimes not getting good grades make a child to lie as small as paper nahi mila hai. Isn't it? Yeah, mera A grade aaya. Later on in the report card, you will find C grade aaya. I mean, these are very petty and small things which all of us can find. But this not necessarily always lead a child to become a thief or rapist or a murderer. Sometimes, I mean, these are the petty things. Later on, it goes on. The child gets admission to some good professional course and becomes some of the other professional. But sometimes, these are the things may perpetuate in a particular person's life and may lead him to commit some further. And many other things which takes place at the school level, sometimes nowadays, sexual abuse is also very common in that. Because as sir already told you, I have my work much more on the child rights. And in my research, I have found out that these are the factors which is becoming much, much more, that the data with regard to things are not available, but it is becoming much higher, especially the children are going to schools. In fact, they are most of the time out of the house. I'm not from Delhi originally, now living in Delhi for the past 25 years, but I remember my childhood in a small town of UP as compared to the children living and studying in Delhi school. They are almost the whole day out first in the schools for so long, from 6 o'clock to 2:30 or 3:30, then going to the coaching classes. Yeah, ma'am.
What is the percentage, as you research, what is the percentage of the juvenile delinquency you've seen in rural and urban areas?
Of course,
then you find more.
With regard to school, it is in urban.
I'm
not talking about juvenile delinquency, not my original. So I'm talking about this sexual and physical abuse in school. I'm referring to only one particular aspect, not the whole juvenile delinquency, but I'm referring to the school conditions which lead the child to have a delinquent behavior. That is the sexual abuse of the child in school. Physical abuse, all of us are aware, corporal punishment, thodi bahut mil jati hai, but with regard to sexual abuse, which is becoming more and more and not being disclosed to the people, but which results into some type of stigma and that and leading the children. And that is my research, as well as one of the research conducted by Ministry of Women and Child Welfare and one NGO Prayas, and they have found out for the first time, not even in the urban schools, even in the rural schools, the sexual abuse in the schools and at the study places is much, much on. In fact, this particular study also find out one factor which was not at all prevalent, that is emotional and psychological. Which is not very easy, or I mean, to define also, what will you call it, psychological or emotional abuse. One child is compared to another child by the parent or by the school teacher. Tum theek ho, tum acha nahi karte ho. So the indicators are very tough within that. And that is happening, and that research is coming up. In fact, in the next research is going on to come much more the data as well. Then you can say the neighboring conditions are also responsible with regard to the juvenile delinquency. This can be proximity to luxury and wealth if the children don't have, congested neighborhood and slums, their loneliness, lack of social outlets, overstimulating movies and shows. Yeah. With regard to the factors which are responsible for delinquency, adolescent instability is one thing which is common, that when the children enter into the age which is after 12 years or 13 years, adolescent age, that time all of us in fact must have experienced, we believe me, mine, my style, we don't want any interference by the elder. That is the state which comes in. That instability, you can say, or you can say biological development also takes place into the body. So that instability is there in the body, which sometimes, not to all the children, but to some children, in terms of juvenile delinquency. That means when they are at that stage, they have some peer pressures also, because of that they start stealing money from the parents first. They start going out and not telling the parents where they are going. They want that they should go to movie shows which are adult in nature. They want certain things which they don't want to, and above all, they don't want to disclose that to their parents. They indulge into those behaviors. So that is adolescent instability, which is not something abnormal, which is very normal. But that normal thing sometimes can become abnormal in certain. Then uncongenial moods, which earlier also I talked, that if the atmosphere in the family, if the circumstances and conditions in the family are such, which leads a child to go into, you know, some of the child are able to tolerate the fights, the discussions, the poverty, the other type of factors, but some of the child, because of that, may run away from the house, may take some other type of steps, and may end up. Then sex indulgence, I'm sorry, associational impact. Associational impact, the friends, the associates, they put a lot of effect in a person's life. We always understand if a child has good friends, then he always is going on to be a good person, good grader, good schooling, and then further leading to good college life or good. But if a child falls into the company or the friends group is not of good people who are not good in studies or who are bandering or who are the people who are into bad things, then obviously this association is going on to have a greater impact and can lead a child into juvenile. Then sex is a risk, especially this is true from time immemorial also, but it is more true nowadays because nowadays children want to experience sex at a very early age. When they enter into this, maybe initially they are in love with somebody or they have good feelings, but later on this can result into a bad habit or into the habit of being consistently into teenage sex, and that can lead them into, because each thing is linked to another thing. For that they may require not getting the permission from the parent, going outside, being with their friend, staying with their friend's house. So that can lead them into delinquency. Then movies. How do you feel movies are responsible to put the children into delinquency? Are the movies responsible?
Basically,
it's showing how a hero eliminates a thing. So sometimes it's a hero, even if that is violence, that is fight, maybe heroic act.
And then they think that, yes, violence is the way to get justice, and that is how they
eliminate
society.
Yeah. Largely, movies are showing what is happening.
Exactly. Now I hit the same sentence I was about is, are the movies reflection of the society or the society reflects the movies? You know, the sentence can be both ways around. Because most of the time, in fact, when we go to the movies, even we watch serials. You remember the title of the serial, Kahani Ghargar Ki. What does it convey? कि वो जो सीरियल में दिखाते, पहले जमाने में हमारे पास कुछ अपना काम करा और पड़ोस के जाके बैठ गए या पड़ोस के आके बैठ गए, वो अपने घर का किस्सा सुना रहे, चाहे वो परेशानी का, चाहे वो खुशी का, और आप अपना किस्सा सुना. टुडे वी डोंट हैव दैट टाइप ऑफ टाइम और दैट टाइप ऑफ हैबिट. टुडे द सेम थिंग वी वॉच ऑन द टीवी.
आई रिमेंबर मार्शबू इन अनाड़ी.
या
सो he confronts some person who was in the party and he got in that party's wallet.
Right.
So he walks with that wallet to searching whose wallet is. So the gentleman is standing over there. देखो कि तुम मनाड़ी जब तुम जो पार्टी में हैं, इनको भी कभी वॉलेट्स ही मिले थे, इन्होंने कभी लौटाए नहीं, तुम लौटा रहे हो. ये है
डिफरेंस.
लौटा रहे हैं वो अनाड़ी.
सो विद रिगार्ड टू मूवीज, हाउ कैन, आई मीन, वी कैन नॉट डेफिनेटली से इट इज वॉचिंग द मूवीज मेक्स अ पर्सन डिफरेंट. इनफैक्ट
Now people are watching these things and learning from it, right? See, I agree with you in these kind of ones where the crime petrol is there.
So
give ideas to the ones who could be, they have that element, and this stimuli works with them.
True.
And where one is aware that
true.
So and it works both.
Yeah, you are right. And then many, with regard to many situations, for example, even with regard to family things, certain things we feel. We may say to the person, we may not, but if watching in a serial or in a movie, we can definitely see she also did the same thing.
So it creates a negative impact, basically, on how things, it might not happen in someone's house, but since she and her mother-in-law sit together and watch that serial, then they also get that hostile environment.
Right. And we start, even sometimes identifying our own people who are around us with regard to some characters, especially. ये तो उसकी तरह behave कर रही है, कोमल का भी तरह कर रही है, उसकी तरह.
That's why in Europe they call it an idiot.
But we are getting more and more used to this idiot, but now in each room.
Why? Because lot of people are, the work pressure is so high that they don't have time to indulge with the real people. So what they have started making friend of the virtuality in their life. So they want to be more virtual,
right.
Have an imaginary friend. If you, if I will be staying alone in the house, the minute first thing will be done, I'll go and open up.
What's your name?
MBB, Anuja Kapoor.
Anuja, when I say this kahani ghar ki, I want to say the same thing. I just, hum wohi kahani ghar mein baith ke dekhte hain, dusron ki ghar ki, and
उससे सेटिस्फाई होते हैं कि ऐसे ऐसे होता अदरवाइज वी यूज वी होप यू सम
ग्रुप्स आर लेस एक्सप्रेसिव सम ग्रुप्स आर मोर एक्सप्रेसिव उनका पीयर ग्रुप इंटरेस्ट नहीं होगा उसके साथ ही लोग कहते होंगे धीरे चलाओ अब वी मेड इट अ पॉइंट कि तीन चार बच्चे किसी गाड़ी में साथ नहीं बैठे वी यूज्ड टू ट्रैवल फ्रॉम नैनीताल टू लखनऊ तो टू कार्स यूज्ड टू गो बच्चे अलग अलग करो अलग गाड़ियों करो उसकी माताओं के साथ बैठाओ बिकॉज चिल्ड्रन विल कहाँ और दे चलाओ और बिकॉज ऑल चिल्ड्रन
दिस इज वन ऑफ द ट्रिप विच यू आर टेलिंग एक्चुअली ग्रुप फॉर्मेशन वो आप दिस
ओके रेस्ट यू डिस्कस दिस इज द टाइम टू रेंट द गेस्ट हाउस Thank you for that excellent talk and soon next session after the lunch. Let's see what is there in the list.